Welcome to MCN and welcome to my long-term test review of the Suzuki GSX250R. So this bike was new for 2017 and comes with a 248cc parallel twin engine, which is derived from Suzuki's old school Inazuma 250 commuter bike. So despite looking quite fast and looking like the bigger GSX-R, this bike does keep you reined in well and truly, and that means that the 250 is only good for roughly 86 miles per hour on the dash. It'll sit at motorway speeds relatively comfortably, but it's quite hard if you want to make progress and really get somewhere in a hurry. That said, that makes the 250 brilliant for teaching new riders things like the art of corner speed, because you really need to keep it up, because there's next to nothing when you leave the corner and twist the throttle. With that in mind, I've just been putting serious miles on it, travelling 110 miles a day from my home in Lincolnshire to the office in Peterborough. So the only modifications that I've done to this bike since I've got it is I've installed a new tank pad, and I've installed it because I thought that the paint was a little bit thin. I have noticed that it started to scratch a little bit around the top of the fuel cap where I've had a tank bag on longer trips. Apart from that, I've done relatively little, and the bike commands relatively little maintenance. You rarely ever have to adjust the chain, just keep lubricating it and it'll be fine. And I've just popped a bit of air in the tyres, and that's about it. I've done a couple of bigger rides and bigger trips on the 250 as well. One of those was a 190 mile ride down south to Crawley. And one of the things I found most interesting, or most obvious on the way, was after about 100 miles, you're gonna wanna have to get off and give your bum a bit of a rest, because this seat is not designed for distance in the slightest. It's comfy on shorter rides and there's plenty of padding, but a 250 is just not designed for touring, and it shows. That said, the upright bars and the screen offer plenty of comfort and plenty of wind protection, so bar the seat, it was perfectly adequate at the job. And even after all those miles down the M25, Dartford Crossing and everything else, the bike was still reading over 70 miles to the gallon. So I can't really complain at that. Another thing that I'm keen to discuss with the 250 is its brakes. Now, you get ABS at the front and the rear, which helps it comply with Euro 4. Now, this is great, and it means it helps it stop better in most conditions. However, I have found at the front that the ABS can be quite unpredictable at times. And sometimes when I've had to make emergency stops, I found that I perhaps could have stopped faster without the ABS in place. Sometimes, when I'm riding over really rutted roads, I find that when I'm under the brakes, the ABS can sometimes kick in there as well. And it can cause the lever to pulsate and push back against my hand whilst forcing it in. And this is quite unnerving to me, having ridden for 6 years. So I dread to think what it would be like for a new rider who just passed their A2 license and jumped on this bike. And that's what this bike is aimed for, really. You know, it starts at £4,299 for the base model, and then it's another £100 more for the GP paint scheme. So it's designed to excite late teens, 19-year-olds to 21-year-olds, to get onto bikes. So the Suzuki's main rivals consist of KTM's RC390, Yamaha's R3, and the Ninja 300. Also in the mix is Honda's CBR300, which means that the GSX250R is obviously down on power on the rest. It's the only 250 in the class. That said, this bike, I feel, would be ideal if all of your riding was done in an urban environment. There's plenty of poke from the 250 engine, and okay, it feels a little bit lost out on the A1 and at motorway speeds. However, in town, there's more than enough go there to nip between cars, filter, and stay ahead of the traffic comfortably. Right then, so we've come out and about now and we've done a bit of exploring on the bike in the twisties, which is a perfect opportunity to talk about the tyres on this bike. Now, this has been a bit of a problem of mine since I've had the bike, with the dimensions of the tyres being slightly awkward. The front of the bike uses a 110 80 17 section tyre and the rear uses a 140 55 17. Now, this means that it's really difficult to get any aftermarket tyres from any of the major manufacturers, which means that you're pretty much left with what you came with as standard, which is IRC's RX01 tyre. Now, this is okay, but it's a budget tyre that's been designed to last going in a straight line, and it's designed to last over distance. It's not designed to offer you feedback or grip in the corners. This is something that I've really struggled with when I've taken the bike out into the twisties. I found the tyres quite wooden and they offer very limited feedback to me when I'm getting on the gas. Now, I've ridden with this bike on these tyres for roughly 4,500 miles now, so I know the limits of the tyres in the dry. So I'm more than happy to push now I've learnt about the bike when I feel that the conditions are adequate. However, in the wet, these really struggle. And a classic case in point is when I'm commuting to and from the office, I find that the front sometimes washes on white lines on the A1. And this is quite disconcerting at about 70 miles an hour when you switch in lanes. And, you know, kind of dents your confidence in a way. Obviously, with the tyres being a bit of a problem for me, you'd have thought that I'd have switched them out now for a more major manufacturer. However, the dimensions that I've discussed mean that most manufacturers only make a tyre that fits either the front or the rear, but not as a full set, which is obviously problematic. This has meant that when after 3,500 miles, the rear of the standard tyres squared off, I was forced to put another set of the standard tyres back on. So away from the tyres, the GSX250R is actually really good fun in the twisties. Despite making just 24.7 horsepower, you can really use the limits of this bike without worrying about getting into trouble too much. I've found personally that you can eke out just a little bit more performance in a straight line if you develop a really comical moto freestyle tuck. Now, you might look a bit ridiculous, but you really can feel the benefits on this bike. And you really have to keep the motor buzzing in and out of corners in order to maintain momentum when you get onto the straights. Unfortunately, winter's on the way, so I have to prepare this bike now in order to take on the grit and the salt and the cold temperatures. So what I'm planning to do with this bike is to turn it into the ultimate winter tool. I want to carry on doing my commute by bike for as long as possible this year before it gets too icy and too dangerous and I have to call it quits and jump in the car. That means, in an ideal world, I'd love to get a nice big hugger on the back in order to keep the grit out of the shock and to make cleaning and maintenance a lot easier. Another thing I'm also keen to do is install some nice warm handguards or muffs in order to keep my hands really warm heading up and down the A1 every morning. Another good addition perhaps would be a bigger screen. Although this one offers plenty of wind protection going up and down the A1, I feel a slightly bigger one would help protect me from the wind chill. Despite having difficulty so far, I'll also look to put on some more tyres perhaps better suited to the cold conditions, if I can find some that fit. I feel like the busiest petrol station on the A1 to do this. Is it still recording? Yeah. Oh, right, okay, fine. Mm-hmm. I'll try that again. Up front, you get a tiny little I bet it's recording that as well, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Welcome to MCN. We're out here, me and Archie, doing our thing. Riding a bike, driving a Honda Jazz about. Rock stars, really. I'll try that again because that was blank. It's actually really well. Colder to just remove. Ah, so crap. Why would I even say that? It's not even good. I feel that a slightly bigger one would offer. I will get there. I found that in order to... what more do you want? It's a 250, mate.